Hello everybody, this is Trilok Singh Bish from Jodhpur Public School, Jammu. Once again for you all with the details of perfect competition market today. Yesterday I told the markets on the basis of competition. We talked about five kinds of markets: monopoly, monopolistic competition market, oligopoly, duopoly and perfect competition market. But today I am taking it one by one. The perfect competition market in detail. When I talk about perfect competition market, got these characteristic features. First is large number of sellers and buyers. When I say large number of sellers and buyers, it means there is so many buyers and sellers that they cannot influence the price in the market. Therefore, we have the uniform prices all through the market. No seller is ready to sell at a lower price to reduce his profit margin, or no buyer is ready to buy at a higher price to reduce his satisfaction level. Therefore, we have the uniform product, or the identical product all over, which is called as homogeneous products. All the products are exactly identical in this market, and there is no necessity of producing something which is a close substitute. That's why we say there is no substitutes are available in this particular market. All the firms are free. Freedom to enter and exit the market. The freedom to enter and exit of the firms is a characteristic feature of perfect competition market. Here the demand is perfectly elastic. I can say if I have to draw a demand curve for the perfect competition market, my demand is going to be like this. X or Y, if I have this here price and here the quantity demanded, then what do you find? My price elastic demand is perfectly elastic. This is my demand curve. EP is equal to infinity, infinite. What is happening here? There is a perfectly elastic demand where we find whether the price, price is same, whether you demand less or you demand more. You are going to pay the same price. That's why it is called as demand is perfectly elastic demand. Then perfectly mobile factors of production. These are the characteristic features of perfect competition market. Now I'll tell you how do we fix the prices. How do we determine the price in the perfect competition market? In the perfect competition market, the price is a free play of demand and supply. You know, when we talk about price is always decided on the basis of demand for and supply of the commodity. If the demand is very high, supply is less, the prices will go up. When the demand is less and the supply is very high, prices will come down. Therefore, on the basis of demand and supply in the industry, the price will be fixed at the point where supply and demand are equal to each other. Quantity demanded and quantity supplied are going to be equal to each other. That is the point where we fix the price. And whatever the price is fixed by the industry, that is taken by the firms. Firms will take the same price whether average revenue and marginal revenue is the same. And it does not change because it's a perfectly elastic demand. And we can say firms are price takers. What do we call this? Firm price takers. Here in this perfect competition market, the firms are price takers. And the second topic today which I am taking is monopolistic competition market. Should be monopolistic competition market, not monopolistic market. Monopolistic competition market. So this is the market which is the most realistic market in which we have many sellers and large number of buyers, and these many sellers have this product differentiation also. What do you mean by product differentiation? When they are, products are there but they are slightly different from each other. They are close substitutes to each other. If I talk about soaps, it will be Lux, it will be Hamam, it will be Dove, it will be so many other brands. But they can't be just a replica of each other. But at the same time, the product differentiation means when the same use is there for the product but they are of different brands and with the different ingredients altogether, that is called as product differentiation. Third is freedom to enter and exit. Any firm can enter this market, any firm can leave the market anytime. Normally what happens, when do the firms want to enter? When a particular business, when an industry is making a lot of supernormal profits. Supernormal profits, profits are so much that everybody is attracted to produce there. So many more sellers, many more firms enter this market. When more firms enter the market, what happens? The supply becomes more. So demand being the same, prices start coming down and they come back to normal profits. Similarly, a firm which is facing a lot of loss. If the firms are facing a lot of loss, what happens? Many firms leave that particular industry. And these firms, when they leave, the supply becomes less and demand is the same. Then as a result, the price starts increasing and they also come to the normal profits. That's what they say, freedom to enter and leave the market anytime. Then some degree of market power or the monopoly power. If I am using my own brand, suppose I have got my own brand, Trilok Singh, Bist's brand of a particular commodity, then I have a monopoly power over my own product. You know, I hope you are understanding what I am trying to tell you, that product monopoly means it's not absolute monopoly, but in your product you have the monopoly, and at the same time, Vikas has a monopoly over his own product. So our products have our own monopoly on our product, but at the same time we have to face the competition because both of us are producing close substitutes to each other. So there will be a competition. So therefore we have a monopolistic competition market, we call it, because element of monopoly is there in the particular product. At the same time, due to the close substitutes or the product differentiation, the competition is also there. Sellers and buyers do not have perfect information, sellers and buyers do not have perfect information regarding the prices and products. If I am going to a particular shop purchasing a thing for 10 rupees, I didn't even make an attempt to go to another shop and find out if it is available for 8 rupees there. So therefore that information is not clear, the knowledge is not there with the buyers that what is the actual price of the commodity. As a result, they get misled and cheated also. Then selling cost or advertisement cost is very important in this particular market because everybody is selling their close substitutes. So everybody wants to face the competition. When there is a competition, boys and girls, what happens? We have to advertise, we have to add on the selling cost. We have to tell that, you know, there's some cine stars, some celebrities, they endorse our product so that, you know, the product demand goes up. So therefore, advertisement cost is very, very important out here. Then the demand curve in this is more than unity demand curve, because when the price goes up, people demand more. As a, when the price comes down, they demand more than proportionately. When it comes to decrease in prices, decrease in price leads to proportionately higher increase in the demand. So this is all about the characteristics. Now I'll quickly tell you how do we fix the pricing in the monopolistic competition market. In this, we fix the price at the point where the MC is equal to MR. What is MC and what is MR? MC is the marginal cost, MR is the marginal revenue. The additional revenue which I am getting, if it is not equal to my marginal cost, then I will not produce. If my cost is more and revenue is less, why would I produce? So therefore this is the point where we are fixing the equilibrium price in the monopoly competition market. There are three cases. One case can be when, you know, marginal cost and average cost is getting, MC and MR is getting at the point. If you see, the price is here, cost is here. So this whole is becoming a, this is losses. We are bearing the losses over here. As soon as we are getting the losses, that's why some of the sellers in this market will leave the market. When they leave the market, what will happen? The supply will become less, demand will be the same, so prices will start going up and it will come to a point where the price and supply are equal. That is, price and cost will be equal. Second case is when MC and MR is selling in such a way that when I extend the sign, I find this is my cost, this is my price. Cost is less, price is more, so this much is my profit. Alright? So I am going to gain the profits in this case. When I am getting supernormal profits, what will happen? Many more producers or sellers would also want to come to this market, and when they come, the supply will increase, demand will be the same, so price will come down, will come back to the normal price, where there is no profit and no loss. And this is the ideal situation where the person keeps producing because the marginal cost and average marginal revenue is coming at such a point where AC is just a tangent to AR. So therefore there will be no profit, no loss. That is just normal profits will be earned by the people, and this is the most ideal situation altogether. I hope I have made myself very clear today. What is monopolistic competition market in a nutshell? What are the characteristics? How do we go about the price determination in the monopolistic competition market? Boys and girls, I hope I have made myself very clear, and I am making it very crisp and very short, not making it a huge lecture where you may not like it at all. So please go through it. Have a quick revision. If there's anything in the comment section, you can ask me anything. You will get the reply to the comments. Thank you so much. Thank you. Ta-ta. Bye-bye. Sayonara.